I got this mail today from my health company. Where is it? It's one of these cameras. Of course, I turned the thing around so you can't read my address. Please do not discard important information from your doctor's office. And I remembered what our little friend, loathly daddy, said. Let's see, where's the address right there? So I can't show that to you. Don't want to show the address to you. Because you'll come and drink my coffee. Well, there's all kinds of things in here. There's this piece of tissue paper. Isn't this lovely? Yes. This is a very beautiful piece of tissue paper. You see that? Isn't that lovely? But it's not for blowing my nose on, no. It's not for blowing my nose on if I can fold it ever back up again, right? There we go. Did you know, it says, did you know? Dear Daniel. Oh my God, I showed you the address. Have to edit that part out. We show you are due or coming due for colorectal cancer screening with the fecal immunochemical test. Colon cancer is the third most commonly diagnosed cancer in the United States. At Kaiser Permanente, we strongly recommend blah, 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 blah. Regular colorectal screening. Well, seems to me I just did it, but that was probably last year. So, now you know what the tissue paper's for. And, look, here's the return mail envelope with the sample tube. Ooh, the sample tube. Oh, look, and here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And you mail it back in this little thing. In this little, you put it in here. Oh, look, here's more. Little. Oh, biohazard. My poop is a biohazard. Oh, and this little thing to wipe with. Oh, isn't that sweet? It isn't funny. Cancer isn't funny. But poop bags and poop tubes are funny. Oh, yeah. Where's the tube? Oh, here it is. Here's the tube. It's in a special little place. Sealed in plastic. Oh, I'm sorry. It's only glued on. Yeah, here we go. Look at that. Just a little poop tube. See, it has a sticker sealing the tube shut. Yeah, I'll show it over to you, too. Okay, there you go. Yes. And one camera is for my friends at blah, blah, blah. And the other camera is for my friends at blah, blah, blah. Yes, well, there's the poop tube. Isn't that sweet? It's all nice and clean now because I haven't pooped yet. Using a permanent pen, write the collection date on your collection tube. Oh, you write the date down before you even collect the poop? How do you know you're going to be able to get a good poop? Lift the toilet seat up. Duh. Like I'm going to take a poop with the toilet seat down? Oh, I am. I'm not going to sit on the cold ceramic poop. What the hell is my battery bleeping for? Shit. And I forgot to put the microphone down. You probably couldn't even hear me. So, lift the toilet seat. Not the lid. I thought it said lift the lid up. Lift the seat up. And then you take this big old piece of tissue paper. And see, it says right there. You put it across the seat. Slip it right in there. Right across the seat. But you know, I was talking with the nurses the last time I did this. And they said to me, open up this little tube. Take the little stick. See, their stick is in floating in. Oh, it's. It, see, it is. It's floating. It has bubbles in it. Yes, you can see the bubbles on this side. Yes. Yes, see the bubble? There's liquid in there. Purifying liquid. You take the thing, open it up, take the stick out, and the information says, do not empty the liquid from the tube. The twisted off top of the tube has a collection stick with a grooved green tip. Dip the grooved tip into your stool. That reminds me of... No, that's another story. Insert the collection stick back into the collection tube. You should hear it click shut. I hope so. If any stool gets on the outside of the tube, wipe it off with toilet paper. Flush the toilet, including the tissue paper, which will not harm your sewer or septic tank. You don't know how bad the pipes are in Mexico. Wrap your collection tube in a small... Oh, this is for wrapping the tube up. I see. You wrap the tube up in this absorbent pad and seal it inside the biohazard bag. Yes, you can do it. It is important. You mail this envelope with your enclosed sample back to us immediately. 3 days or sooner. The last time I took one of these tests, I was talking to the nurse on the phone about it, and she said, just wipe your butt and put some of that poop on it. Take poop off your toilet paper and put it on the test. I said, oh, that's a lot easier, isn't it? You just go to the bathroom, and then wipe it off, and then you take a stick and take a little bit off the toilet paper. Well, I hope that doesn't mean I have cancer in a different part of my poop that would have been found. No. Can I complete this test if I have rectal bleeding? No. Wait until the bleeding stops. This test is looking for traces of blood in your stool. There's no copay. Is it okay if my stool touches the urine or toilet water? Yes, it's okay if your stool touches urine or toilet water. If I completed this test last year, that's me, I completed this test last year, do I have to complete it again? Yes. The test is convenient and can be done in the privacy of your own home. But the results are only good for 1 year.
Because after a year, your poop dries up, it's no good anymore.
Do I need to change my diet or medications? No, you don't need them. Is it okay to collect a stool sample if I have diarrhea or constipation? How can I have a stool sample if I have constipation? Really? But yes, it is. The texture of your stool does not matter. Oh, maybe you stick a stick up your butt. If you can't get the poop to come out, you put the stick up your butt. I just made that up. It's not true. Don't believe a word of it. How much stool do I need? How much stool could a stool tool test if a stool test could test stool? You need enough stool to completely cover the grooved green tip of the collection stick, which is, green? It's not green. I can't see inside the label there. You need enough stool to completely cover the grooved green tip of the collection stick. The grooved green tip of the collection stick. Does my stool sample go to bed? What? Oh, does my stool sample go bad? Or do I need to refrigerate the collection tube? No, you do not need to refrigerate the collection tube. Your stool sample lasts up to 7 days after it is collected. That's why it's very important to mail your completed kit back to us as soon as possible. Within 3 days. Oh, I thought they meant you have to do it right now, today. You gotta do it within 3 days. No, you have to mail it within 3 days of when you poop on the stick. Poop on a stick? Sounds like a... I ain't gonna go there. Does the kit expire? Yes, the kit does expire. Look for the expiration date. Oh, there's my name printed on it. Damn, people know who I am. Collection date, collection time. Look for the expiration on the collection tube label. The date listed is XXXXX. Oh, there it is. It says 2017-09. See that? I'll show it to you over here, too. Hey, 2017-09. So it's good until 9 o'clock in the morning. It's good until September. Hell, that's after I'm going to see the eclipse. I could call this eclipse video number 2, since I just mentioned the eclipse. No. De parte del su doctor, nos gustaría agradecerle por hacerse esta prueba de detección gratuita.